What up, Nicky Cuba here. Team Infamous, rolling JT Splatmaster contest going down. 5-on-5.
Thomas Taylor here. You're about to see a 5-on-5 JT Splatmaster battle, and guess what? Nicky Cuba is going down.
Dude's a clown out on the field. I'm gonna mess him up.
Hey, do our teams have names? Winners, losers, got it. Okay, good.
My team versus some little troll living underneath a little bridge with little hands.
Nicky Cuba, down, done. Zip, zilch, nada.
Hit the target, bro.
Hey, see that dead
That's
center?
That's all me.
That's what I'm going to do to your face here in a little bit,
yeah,
right?
Okay,
right there. Gunshots.
Don't break your leg, Thomas.
I don't
oh, wait,
it.
It's already broken.
I don't
broken.
Even got to run you down.
Look at that.
Look at, I'm already out of ammo because I shot your face
every
so much.
Single one.
Splatmaster, it's fun. Competitive. Going down center court. Thomas Taylor's going to win. You heard it here.
All right, here we go. JT Splatmaster experience on center court. Thomas Taylor's team versus Nicky Cuba's team. I'm Maddie Marshall. I'm up here with Rich Telford. So Rich, man, new product out, really big for the kids, huge for the sport. You know, it's all about getting the youth involved, and you guys created a product that, you know, it's a legendary name. Back in the day, that was one of the guns that started this whole sport, and now we've got the new JT Splatmasters out there. It's really exciting, actually.
Yeah, it's huge. Like, you and I have seen everything 10 or 15 times, right?
Uh-huh.
This is the first thing I've seen that is just mind-blowingly good for paintball. No, everybody get behind this because it's growing paintball.
And here we go, just about to start. We got some kids out there again. Oh, a little false start. But I think Nicky Cuba's team tried to, oh, and they're going to restart? Or no, they're going at it right now.
Oh, they are
they
going,
are
at,
going
it.
At it. Yeah, so Nicky Cuba's team leaving early. That was probably Nicky's idea.
Probably.
He was probably like, hey, when you hear 2 seconds.
Oh, he bucked him out of the A.
So it looks
like. Another two guys straight out of the A.
So Nicky Cuba's team's in the black, and Thomas Taylor's team is in the white. Oh! Now
the kid in the white's got the flag. Thomas' kid got the flag. Now, two Nicky's guys got shot.
So, Rich, they're using the red ones. There's two different versions of the Splatmaster.
Okay, they both got the Z200s, which is the shotgun version.
Mm-hmm.
It holds 15 balls. It's pump action. It shoots about 140 to 150 feet per second. Shoot amazingly straight and amazingly well. Super high quality.
Well, the thing is, I actually got to shoot one of those yesterday. I put it in my hand, and when you look at it, you know, you're like, oh, okay, it's, you know, looks like a squirt gun. But when you put it in your hand, it's sturdy. I mean, I don't know
solid.
What sort of spring is involved in that, but the way that it's constructed, and then it doesn't hit very hard, so it's really safe for the kids. I shot myself in the hand just to kind of get a feel for it, you know? And yeah, it hurt a little bit because I shot myself point blank, but it wasn't that bad, so.
It's not like paintball.
No, and it looks like, yeah, it's a 50 cal bullet,
yep.
50 cal paintballs, and here it looks like Nicky Cuba's team. They have the advantage as far as he's got a bigger bunker there to work with.
Yeah,
the field position.
I think it's Thomas has got two kids left and Nicky's got one. Oh, and Nicky's last player goes down. Wow, it's the big kid too. Look at the little guy going for the flag.
Up, so he's going to grab the flag.
There he goes. Oh, Nicky's not going to be happy about that, folks.
So Nicky Cuba's team losing the point there.
That's got to be an upset, man. Nicky definitely had the advantage.
Well, I was going to say, look, is Nicky Cuba stacking his team with the big kids?
Oh, his kids are on steroids. Well, I'm telling you right now.
Okay,
that's performance-enhancing drugs
at
its
Thomas
finest.
Okay, so Thomas is a lot smaller than Nicky to start with. So did he pick the smaller crew?
You know what? Thomas picked the smaller crew, but you know what? Those kids, I was talking to them before, and they were like, we're going to win. And I'm like, well, guys, we're just out here to have fun. No, we're going to win.
Oh,
and I'm
so,
like, I like your attitude,
so
kid.
They got the competitors out there.
I'll get a couple of those kids' excessive jerseys tomorrow. Going back to the guns, though,
mm-hmm.
We did what paintball doesn't do. We didn't come out with a product and say, hey, you know, we've been working on this for 2 weeks. Let's get it out.
Mm-hmm.
We tested this thing for 18 months
mm-hmm.
before we put it on the market. So we're on our fourth or fifth or sixth version of the gun before we sold the first one.
Mm-hmm.
So the quality is super high. We're selling them at Walmart. We're selling them at Kmart, JTSplatmaster.com. They're only $39.
Well, here's the important. This is why this is actually important. Because a lot of the salty veterans out there will be like, okay, well, why are we watching kids shoot each other with toy guns? Here's why. The reason why, and this is why it's fundamentally important for the sport of paintball, is the children and the youth, they need to get involved. You know, and when we started playing, you couldn't even play paintball. There was no access to this. So kids are out there doing dangerous stuff with BB guns. I mean, you know, you're doing that sort of stuff. And this is a really safe way to get the kids involved with something that's not going to hurt a lot. It's really safe as long as all the precautions are taken. And it won't scare them away from the game.
And as a field owner, the worst thing that can ever happen for me is for the kid to come out and play paintball and walk out the field crying because he got hurt.
Yeah.
And he got shot in the finger, he got shot in the neck, and it breaks your heart because you're like, that kid's not only going to not play again, he's going to tell 10 other kids not to play. These kids go out to my field and play, and they're smiling all day long, and they're telling every one of their friends how much fun they had, how much fun it is, how easy it is to play.
So are you carrying these in your store
as
well?
In the store and at the field.
Okay. And how's the reception been?
It's awesome.
Because it's another cool thing, too, because if you're, let's say, here we go. Oh, wow. They're just going to run all the way to the center, start shooting each other. They came up with the same game plan, and Nikki Cuba's team looks like taking it to Thomas Taylor's team. Again, Thomas Taylor's team is in the white. Nikki Cuba's team is in the black.
And he missed him.
Hey, Nikki Cuba's team left somebody, though, in the back to almost to guard the flag, and then he's going to run up. Got to keep that gun up there. catches him slipping.
That little kid was great, though. See, that little kid just shot against three or four guys, point-blank range, not crying, having fun, missed the first guy, turned, got the second guy, and they're having, you know what I mean? They're having fun, and they're going to come out and play paintball again and again. So they come out at 8 or 9 and play paintball for 2 or 3 or 4 years, and when they're good at it and when they're confident, they say, hey, you know what? This isn't enough for me anymore. Then they come play 68 caliber paintball, and that's what we want, right?
Yeah.
If we grow paintball, it's great for everybody.
You have to have that, the ability to move up. You know, you have Little League for baseball. You have Pop Warner for football. Well, with paintball, there's a big barrier to entry to little kids.
Not anymore.
And that's why this product was created, and that's why it's important for the sport, you know? So it's great. I mean, whose idea was this? Were you going to take credit for this?
I would like to say it's Rich Telford's idea, but it's John Robinson's idea.
Okay.
And he got a lot of resistance. There's a lot of resistance out there to change. As always, there's resistance to change.
To change, you know? Yeah.
And I see posts on our Splatmaster page all the time on, oh, it's not as good as airsoft, it's not as good as paintball. It's not supposed to be. It's an entry-level sport. You go out, and just like you said, with Pop Warner and Little League, well, this is the Little League or Pop Warner for paintball.
Yeah, well, that's like saying that, okay, well, Pop Warner's not as good as high school football.
or professional football.
No one even talks about that. That's
ridiculous, right?
Yeah, that's completely
But you know
ridiculous.
How paintball is. You get your haters online all the time. I have yet to have someone come out, because I've been doing events. I did 2 events in Virginia. I did one in Arkansas. We just did one with 1,000 Boy Scouts.
And 1,000 Boy Scouts?
1,000 Boy Scouts in one day. And every one of those kids smiles and gets back in line and wants to go through again and again and again.
Well, if they were using the same guns that the pros are using out here.
Forget about it.
Well, they'd be getting chicken winged and be walking off.
They wouldn't have played the second game,
well,
I guarantee
it. Well, these kids are ages, you know, 9 to 11. And I think there's a couple 12-year-old ringers on Nikki Cuba's team. That doesn't surprise me. Nikki Cuba sending them all the way up to the A.
Oh, look at the guy in the A just got shot in the foot. He's jumping around.
Yeah, so.
Seeing the little guy isn't scared to go get the big guy. Look at that shot.
Did he get a shot on him?
You got him.
Yeah, and he's running off. But but Nikki Cuba's playing, again, treachery, stealing the flag.
Oh, look,
and
Nikki's guys are turning on themselves. Classic Nikki Cuba team, turning on each other and shooting each other.
And there's still a player left alive for Thomas Taylor's team.
He's got 3 guys left alive.
Oh, yeah, he does have. Oh, yeah, they're in the backfield just
hanging out back
there.
I don't think people are going out anymore when they get shot. Yeah, that kid with the flag got shot, went back, his own guy shot him, he's still playing.
Did we add reincarnation rules for
this
last point?
Well, you know, again, Nikki Cuba is very competitive, and Nikki Cuba likes to win, so he's going to get some kids with some performance-enhancing drugs. They're going to get up the field, and they're going to stay in there all day long if that's what they have to do.
So here comes Nikki Cuba's team now pushing up the field. And how many rounds does the
15 rounds.
Okay, 15 rounds.
Yeah.
And then the pistol, how many rounds?
7 rounds. And the pistol has magazines, but we also have tubes for the shotgun, so you can easily just reload the tube.
Okay.
Look, they don't know the little guy's left in the corner.
Oh, they're sleeping on him.
Oh, he gets
him. Hung the flag in time. And, oh, the horn blows.
Tough call. Tough call for those referees. Yeah. I wouldn't want to be a referee down there right now.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to be a referee either. But so Thomas Taylor's team. Getting a little beat up there.
Down 2-1. They came out strong.
No, I think that they basically took the
victory
there.
Oh, look,
Thomas
has got a gun now.
What is Thomas doing?
He looks like he might be shooting at Nikki.
That wouldn't surprise me. I think he just shot Nikki in the back.
Oh, Nikki is now shooting at
it's devolved.
Now we got a pro one-on-one.
It's completely devolved. And now
who could have called this before the game?
Who are you taking?
I'm going to take Thomas. I got it, right?
All right, I'll take Nikki. All right, who's going to win? They're locked in a snap shooting battle. Thomas. Oh, Thomas is go. Oh, Thomas goes.
Oh,
throw
Thomas goes for a tube in the pocket.
Oh, look at Nikki.
Nikki doesn't have any paint. Nikki doesn't have any paint. Thomas brought a new
either.
Tube. No, Thomas brought a tube out of his pocket just now.
Did Nikki forget to?
I think Thomas just reloaded. Oh, Nikki's reloading. Nikki's
reloading.
Now Thomas makes a big move. Nikki makes a big move.
Did Nikki get
look
shot?
Look at that athleticism
at
out there. Nikki can't reload. He can't reload.
He can't reload. Oh, now they're just going to get right next to each other.
And you know what's funny, Matt, is this is how a lot of our practices end now. I bring the guns to practices, and we shoot each other at the end of practice every time. It's a blast. Thomas Taylor gets a victory.
Hey, Thomas Taylor takes the victory, but I think Nikki is saying that Thomas cheated, but it's hugs all around.
The kids are turning on him.
Get him. Get
him, kids.
Get him.
Oh, look at the little guy chasing him down. That was awesome. That's the most fun that's been out here all day, other than when we smashed Tampa Bay Damage. I mean, that was fun, but that could have been more fun out there.
Yeah, so, but again, really important for the development of the youth.
Honestly, this is the biggest thing that's happened for paintball in the last 600 years.
Yeah, well, you know, when I first heard about it, I was like, they came out with the, I didn't really quite get it. And then as soon as you broke it down for me, because I saw the press release.
I did the exact same thing
I saw the press release, and I was like, okay, that's cool. But then you started breaking it down. You're like, no, look, you know I own a field. I'm like, yes, I own a store. I'm like, I got that. I've known you for years. Why are you telling me this? Because like, I'm trying to make a point. I'm like, okay, go ahead, Rich.
Stop talking to me.
And then you said, well, look. We have a big issue, or we had a big issue, trying to get those kids. Because you know how it is. A lot of people always ask you, how old can a kid be to play? 7, 8, too young, you know?
Yeah, and sometimes 12 is too young if you got a sensitive kid, you know?
Yeah, it really depends. But then the pain threshold's always been an issue. But these don't hit too hard. You know, like I said, I shot myself in the hand just because I wanted to, you know, see if you were actually telling me the truth or not.
Because I pulled a few fast ones on you in the past.
Yeah, and it hurt, you know, I mean, because I shot myself point blank, but it wasn't really that bad. So
and I think if you can imagine these kids going out with a chest protector on,
yeah,
a hooded sweatshirt, and some thick sweats playing,
yeah,
I don't think anyone of them would get hurt all day long.
Well, you could do it, you know, in your backyard. I mean, there's a lot of people.
The first game I played was in the backyard with our trash cans from the alley with my kids. And we played for 4 or 5 hours, and we were laughing and giggling the whole time. And the best thing is I ran out of ammo once. 8-year-old kid comes down and bunkers me. It was awesome.
Yeah, well, it's like I grew up on a canyon when I was a kid, and, you know, we were out there constantly with slingshots and BB guns and, you know, doing things we probably shouldn't have done, and we didn't have this option.
Right, exactly.
You know, it is really cool to see this because we know how important it is to get them while they're young and just let them understand that how fun paintball can be.
Exactly.
So, and also, it's a legendary name. Splatmaster was one of the markers that started this sport.
It sure did.
So it's cool that you guys named it that.
Yeah, and one thing that's cool as an adult is, you know, we like to go camping and stuff like that, but you don't want to haul CO2 tanks or compressed air tanks.
And you don't need any of that.
You can take a couple of these, a case of paint, and play in the woods with your buddies for 2 days and have a blast.
Yeah. Well, hey, thanks for sitting up here with me.
Thank you.
I know it's going to be a good product, or it's going to be a successful product. So thank you guys for tuning in. It's JT Splatmaster Experience, Matty Marshall, Rich Telford, and looks like Thomas Taylor was the victor here today. We'll see you guys in just a second.
Thanks, guys.